Today's Spotlight is brought to you in part by presenting sponsor, First Community Financial Bank, the community bank where you come first.
If you're just tuning in, you're watching Spotlight. My second guest is the Ronald McDonald Family Room in Edward Hospital. And joining me today, we have Carrie Gillespie, who is a volunteer and a former charity family. And we have Lori Chevalier, who's also a volunteer. So welcome.
Thank you.
We're going to start with you, Lori. Tell us a little bit about the room. Tell us about the Ronald McDonald Room at Edward.
The Ronald McDonald Family Room at Edward Hospital is your home away from home for the families that have a child that's there in the hospital who's sick. When you walk into the family room, you feel like home. You don't feel like you're in the hospital. There's two sitting rooms with couches and chairs, with TV with the DVD player. There's two workstations with two computers. There's a kitchenette where we have donated food items, that snacks, and there's stuff in the refrigerator that's been donated as well. We have a playroom for the kids. It's connected on the pediatric ward so they can come in through there or through the family room. We also have a bathroom shower room that has its own towels and toiletries for families that would like to just get away and get cleaned up. And then we also have two sleep rooms. And in each sleep room, they have their own bathrooms.
Okay. Carrie, you've experienced, unfortunately, the experience of being in the hospital with your child for a long period of time. Tell us a little bit about why something like this is so important.
So that is correct. My son was in the hospital for a total of 10 months, and this was back in 2008. And back at that time, Edward Hospital didn't have the family room, and there was really no place to go for respite. And there were several times where I was at the hospital around the clock, my husband and I both. And the only place to go was really the lunchroom down in the main lobby. So there's really no place to go. And also to take a quick 30-minute nap. There was absolutely nowhere. And fortunately, part of the time my son was in the hospital was down at University of Chicago, and I did have the opportunity to stay at the Ronald McDonald House. So right. I got to experience that firsthand, and I'm just so grateful that the charity brought the family room to the hospital.
Yeah, it really, I can't imagine first going through that, but that opportunity, as best as you can, to have a little bit of a break and be able to regroup.
Mm-hmm. It's priceless. I mean, just for that respite. And also, you know, what we find is that many families, including myself, when you're in the family room, you know, sometimes you just want a quiet time. Yeah. And other times you want to talk to other families, and you do gain strength in talking to other families that are going through similar situations.
Absolutely, that ability to connect. Mm-hmm. What drew you to volunteer it?
Well, I wanted to give back to the community. I used to be a first grade teacher, and I haven't worked since I've had children, and I have a heart to help others. So I thought when the family room was being built, I jumped in on that and started to get involved. So,
and tell me, give me an example of just something that's been really touching to you or as your experience.
Oh, I have to say, it wasn't too long ago. There was a teenage girl in the playroom who she was just drawing. And I went in there to talk to her, see if she wanted some company, and I didn't realize it was her birthday. And when she went back to the room, her family had brought her a cake. And right before my shift was ending, she came running down to give me a piece of cake to say thank you for sitting down with her and talking with her.
Oh,
so that was
something.
That was my
absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. Now, there are lots of different ways that volunteers can help out mm-hmm. at the Ronald McDonald Room. Tell us a few of those. Give us some examples of different ways that volunteers can help.
Sure. So there's several ways, as you mentioned. One of the ways is that you can have a meal catered to the family room. You can collect the pop tabs for the family room. And there's several ways.
You can go to RonaldHouseChicago.org, and you can find Edward Hospital on there, the family room, and there we have a wish list
okay.
of items that we need. Since we don't have a lot of storage space there, you know, at least we can itemize what we need.
Okay. And then do families bring those to the house? So on the wish list, do I then go and I might bring that stuff to you?
Make a phone call, and then we'll set up an appointment to get it dropped off.
Mm-hmm. Okay,
yeah.
Terrific.
Families
yeah.
do support the family room in several ways. I had a family on Christmas Eve that came in with wrapped presents for all the children that were in the hospital during Christmas. I thought that was just absolutely amazing.
Oh, that's incredible.
My husband, he had a ping pong tournament, and instead of having all the men win money, monetary prizes, I said, why don't you, none of you guys need the money. I said, why don't you donate the money to the family room? And so they did, and they had a big chunk of money that went directly to the family room.
That's great. So lots of different ways that people can give of their time,
sure,
can
absolutely
bring stuff, can donate money.
Mm-hmm.
Talking about money, you have a couple of fundraisers coming up. Mm-hmm. Tell us a little bit about those.
We have a wine tasting, Uncork Your Support, in March at Crest Creek Country Club. And then in May,
we have the Pop It and Drop It. It's an activity. It's not necessarily a fundraiser.
Okay.
But that's where a couple of the schools are getting involved, and they're going out in the community and raising awareness of the family room and asking everyone to save your pop tops.
Yep. One student from District 203 and one student from District 204 that's going to be getting the areas aware of the drive.
I think we got information on that, which I think is great, because it's not only is raising awareness of what the house does, but it's also a very simple way to help out. I like the fact that we're dropping at Edward Hospital. I think it's so good to be able to come actually to the place of service. So that's great. And then they're going to recycle that. Is that right?
Yep. That's correct.
And sell it, and then that money goes back to the room.
Directly to the charities. Mm-hmm.
That's great. That's great. So tell me a little bit, as you guys, when you're in there and you're thinking about how important this is, what do you think, what would be the one thing you would say to our viewers about the importance of this room?
To make it their home away from home while they're at the hospital. I mean, truly, you want them to come in and be relaxed and hopefully get a little bit of the stress that's in their day gone for a few minutes at least.
Okay. It's a much needed break from the craziness of the hospital. Mm-hmm. And like I said, I know that firsthand. And it truly is a blessing to have that family room there. And, you know, many of the families, write us letters and tell us how grateful they are.
Oh, that's great. Well, thank you for the good work that you guys are doing and the volunteer work that you're showing on behalf of families like yours who have had to experience that, and families who haven't experienced it but have a giving heart and want to give back. So thank you so much. We're going to take a short break, and we'll be right back with more Spotlight.